हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज द थर्ड वीडियो इन द सीरीज ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चंस फॉर जेईई मेंस एंड नीट। लेट अस सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर। द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द हीट फ्लोइंग फॉर 10 सेकंड्स थ्रू ए रॉड ऑफ लेंथ 40 सेंटीमीटर्स एंड एरिया 50 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर इज 200 जूल्स। इफ द टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस एट द एंड ऑफ द रॉड इज 80 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, देन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ द रॉड इज। वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ के हियर। सो लेट अस कंसिडर द इक्वेशन ऑफ कंडक्टिविटी। Equation of conductivity is dq by dt will be equals to ka into delta t upon L. Now substitute all the given values here. dq is given as 200 joules, dt is 10 seconds, k value we have to calculate, area is 50 centimeter square, convert it into meter square into 10 power minus 4 into delta t is 80 divided by L. L is given as 40 centimeters. Again, that will be 40 into 10 power minus 2. So this will be 10 power minus 2. This is 2 times. Again, this will be 10 will get cancelled out. So here we can write 20 will be is equals to k into this we can add it as 0.5. 0.5 and 2 will get cancelled out. So k will be is equals to 20. This will be the solution for this question. Let us see the next question here. Here again, next question is related to heat transfer. The question given is, two rods of same area having conductivities 60 and 40 are and lengths 0.2 meter and 0.3 meters are connected in series to each other. The effective conductivity of the combination is. So here, two rods are kept in series. One rod is having a length 0.2 meters and other rod is having a length 0.3 meters. Here conductivities are 60 and 40. We have to calculate the effective conductivity. Let us consider one single rod of length 0.5 meters and let us assume area of cross section is A and K equivalent as K. So here resistance of first rod, resistance of any rod can be written as L by K. So resistance of first rod will be 0.2 upon 60 into A plus 0.3 upon 40 into A is equals to 0.5 upon K into A. So here this A and points will get cancelled out. A will get cancelled out. Now take 20 common here. 1 by 20 into this will be 2 by 3. And this will be 3 by 2 is equals to 5 by k. So if you take the LCM, this will be 1 by 20 into 4 plus 9. 4 plus 9 will be 13 divided by 6 is equals to 5 by k. So this is 120. 120 into 5 will be 600. So k will be is equals to 600 upon 13. You see the calculation, approximately it will be is equal to 46.15. That will be the solution for this question. Let us go to the next one. So here the question is related to circular motion. The question given is, the condition of weightlessness can be created momentarily when the plane flies over the top of a vertical circle at a speed of 900 kilometers per hour. The radius of the vertical circle that the pilot must use is. So let us assume this is the circular path covered by that pilot. When he is at the maximum position, he is having weightlessness. Weightlessness means there will be no normal reaction or any contact with any body. If there is no normal reaction acting on the pilot, the only force acting will be gravitational force. This gravitational force will provide the required centripetal force required for the circular motion of the body. Let us assume the radius of this circle as r. So if you write the force equation in the radial direction, that is mg will be is equals to mv square by r. So m will get cancelled out here. So r will be is equals to v square by g. Here it is given in kilometers per hour. First let us convert it into meters per second. So this is 900 into 5 by 18. This will be 50. 50 into 5 will be 250. So r will be is equals to 250 into 250 divided by 10. So 250 into 25. 25 25 will be 625. So this is 6250 meters. We want it in kilometers. So this will be 6.250 kilometers. This will be the solution for this one. Let us see the next one. So the next question given is, a body of mass 1 kilogram is rotating in a vertical circle of radius 1 meter. What is the difference in its kinetic energies at the top and the bottom of the circle in joules? Let us assume this is our circle. The bottommost velocity, let us take it as VB, and the topmost velocity, let us take it as VT. When a body is moving in circular motion, the tension or the normal reaction, whatever may be the cause, will not be doing any work on the body. If you see, let us assume it is connected to a string here. The tension and displacement are always perpendicular to each other. The only force which is going to work on this particle is gravitational force. So according to work energy theorem, we can say that net work done will be equal to change in kinetic energy. When a particle is moving in circular motion, vertical circular motion, only one thing is going to work on that particle, that is gravity. So work done by gravity will be equal to kinetic energy final, which is kinetic energy at the top minus kinetic energy initial, which is kinetic energy at the bottom. So this difference, kinetic energy at the top minus kinetic energy at the bottom, will be equal to displacement is in upward direction, gravity will be in downward direction. So work will be negative minus mg into height transferred will be 2r. When it is moving from one end of the diameter to other end of the diameter, its displacement will be 2r. So mg into 2r. Just substitute the values here. Minus m is given as 1, g is 10 into 2r. R is again equals to 1. So this will be minus 20 joules. If you just want the magnitude of the difference, that will be equal to 20 joules. Let us see the next question here. Again, this is a similar question. Vertical circular motion. The body of mass 5 kilograms is filled in a vertical circle by a string 1 meter long. Calculate velocity at the top of a circle for just looping the vertical loop. When it is just looping the vertical loop, we already know the standard values here. At the bottommost point, its velocity will be root 5gf. At horizontal position, its velocity will be root 3gr. And at the topmost points, its velocity will be root gr. So we want the topmost point velocity means root gr. Here g will be 10 and r will be 1. So this is root 10, which is approximately equal to 3.1 meters. This will be the solution for the question. Units will be meter per second. We are speaking about velocities here. Let us see the next question here. Here this is related to thermal conductivity, heat transfer. It is given that rod CD of thermal resistance 5 Kelvin per watt is joined at the middle of an identical rod AB as shown in the figure. The ends A, B and D are maintained at 100, 0 and 25 degrees respectively. The heat flowing through the CD is. So here AB and CD are identical rods, means if this is having a resistance of 5 Kelvin per watt, AB will also have resistance of 5 Kelvin per watt. Here C is exactly the midpoint, so I can say AC will have 2.5 resistance and CB will have 2.5 Kelvin per watt resistance. Now I will just redraw it here in terms of resistance. This is point C and this is point D. This is A, C, B. The resistance of this rod is given as 5. This will be half of the 5, 2.5, and this will be half of 5, 2.5. A is at 100 degrees centigrade. B is at 0 degrees centigrade. C is at 25 degrees centigrade. Let us assume the temperature here is T. Now, the net current coming out of a junction will be equal to 0. Kirchhoff's current law, net current coming out of a junction will be equal to 0. So if I apply Kirchhoff current law here, then I can write T minus 0 by 2.5 plus T minus 100 by 2.5 plus t minus 25 by 5 should be equal to 0. T minus 0 by 2.5, t minus 100 by 2.5, t minus 25 by 5 will be equal to 0. If I multiply this total equation with 5, this will be 2t plus 2t minus 200 plus t minus 25 is equals to 0. So here this will be 4t plus t, 5t is equals to 200 plus 25, 225. Means here t will be is equals to 45 degrees. We want the heat current flowing through CD. Heat current dq by dt will be is equals to temperature change divided by thermal resistance. Temperature change here is 45 minus 25. That will be 20 divided by thermal resistance of rod CD is given as 5. So 25 by 5, this will be 4 watt. This will be the solution for this question. Let us see the next one here. This is related to kinematics. Here it is given that a ball of mass 50 grams falls from rest vertically downwards through a distance of 40 meters. Find the kinetic energy and final velocity of the ball. We know that final velocity is nothing but equal to root 2gh. If a ball falls for a height h, its final velocity will be equal to root 2gh. Just substitute the values here. This will be root 2 into 10 into h, 40. So this 2 into 4 will be 2 root 2. And this 10 into 10 will come out as 10. Root 2 value is 1.414. 1.414 into 2, 2.828 into 10. So this will be 28.28 meters per second. This will be the velocity. If you know the velocity, we can find out kinetic energy, half mv square. Or I can also apply work energy theorem. Work energy theorem is net work done will be equal to change in kinetic energy. Here gravitational force is going to do some work. So work done by gravitational force will be equal to final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Initially it is starting from rest, so its initial kinetic energy will be equal to 0. Work done by gravitational force on a freely falling body will be equal to mgh, will be equals to ke final. So here just substitute the values. M value is given as 50 grams. Convert this into kilograms, 50 into 10 power minus 3 into g value is 10 into h value is 40. So this 0, 0, 0 will cancel out this. So we are left with 5 into 4, which will be 20 joules. This will be the solution for this question. Let us see the next one. Next one is again related to thermal conductivity and also we can say calorimetry. So the question given is one end of a metal rod of length 0.6 meters and area 120 centimeter square is in boiling water and the other end is in melting ice. If 0.36 kilograms of ice melts per minute, the coefficient of thermal conductivity of rod is. We know the conductivity equation is dq by dt is equals to ka delta t upon L. Now, here we are given information about dq. That is 0.36 kilograms is melt per second. 0.36 kilograms of ice is melt per second. We know that to melt 1 kilogram of ice, we require 336 into 10 power 3 joules. So to melt 0.36 kilograms, we will be requiring 0.36 into 336 into 10 power 3 joules. So just substitute it here. dq will be equal to 0.36 into 336 into 10 power 3 divided by t is given in minute here. 1 minute will be 60 seconds. Substitute it here. Will be is equals to k into area is given in centimeter square. So just convert it 10 power minus 4 into delta T. One end is boiling and other end is at ice. So temperature difference will be 100 minus 0 divided by L. L is again in meters. Keep it as it is. Just see the calculation of this once. This will be approximately equal to 940.8 MKS units. Let us see the next question here. Again, next question is something similar to the previous one. Here, Just note down this. This is in CGS units, in calories. So the question given is, a rectangle block of copper of thickness 10 centimeters and area of cross section 20 centimeters square has one of its face maintained at a constant temperature of 100 degrees centigrade, while the opposite face is in contact with ice at 0 degrees centigrade. If there is no heat loss, the amount of ice that melts in 20 minutes is. So here we know that dq by dt will be is equals to Ka delta T upon L. Let us assume that m grams of ice is melting, because everything is in CGS system. I am taking m grams of ice is melting. Remember this point, I am taking it as grams. So dq can be written as m into Lf divided by dt. Dt is 20 minutes, that is 20 into 60 seconds is equals to k is 0.9 into A is given as 20 into temperature difference is 100 divided by L is 10. Here latent heat of fusion is 80. Just see the calculation of this. So M will be equals to 2700 grams. You want this in kilograms, so this will be equals to 2.7 kilograms. This will be the solution for this question. Let us see the next one. So here this is a question related to kinetic energy, mainly conversion of density. So let us see the question here. A river of salty water is flowing with a velocity of 2 meter per second. If the density of the river water is 1.2 gram per cc, then the kinetic energy of each cubic meter of water is. So here it is given in gram per cc, convert it into kg per meter cube. To convert gram per cc into kg per meter cube, we have to multiply it with 1000 into 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. That is nothing but 1200 kg per meter cube. We know that kinetic energy is nothing but half mv square. Here we want mass of 1 cubic meter water. Mass can be written as density into volume into v square. Just substitute the values here. Density is 1200. And volume is 1 meter cube into v square into 2 square. So 2 will get cancelled. So this will be equals to 2500 joules. You want it in kilojoules. So this will be equal to 2.4 kilojoules. We will end this session here. I will again meet you with 10 more questions tomorrow. Thank you and subscribe for more content.